Thank you, Siddika, for inviting me. I am Konstantinos Stouras, currently on the faculty at UCD, and this joint work with Sanjeev Arad from UC San Diego and Casey Lifton from Google. So in this paper, we study dueling innovation contests. In contest theory, the case of a monopolistic content designer and the case of perfect competition among content designers are both well understood. We know how to design monopolistic contests or contests with perfect competition under a plethora of different settings and different information structures. Much less is known for the case of two competing content designers, or more generally, for a small and finite number of content designers. So this paper studies innovation contests on a platform. One of the most well-known platforms to host innovation contests is Innocentive. Since we all use Innocentive to motivate our talks for innovation contests, and you should be familiar with it, allow me to use it as well. But with an important observation, solvers who visit Innocentive have multiple contests to choose from. And these contests run in parallel, concurrently, and they compete for solvers. So here are two things that are particularly interesting about Innocentive. The first observation is that a platform can influence solver participation positively or negatively by displaying a given contest more prominently than others. In fact, crowdsourcing platforms such as Innocentive, 99designs, Witmart, or Kaggle regularly promote such featured contests at the top of their website to draw solvers' attention. So platforms' use of featured contests is our first key observation. A second key observation is that contests attract a different number of solvers. Solvers can choose which contest to join, and firms that host contests cannot guarantee a certain number of participants a priori. Naturally, when a firm designs contest, it cannot be sure with certainty how many solvers the contest will attract. So there is participation uncertainty, and combined with solvers' contest self-selection, we have something we will call endogenous and uncertain participation. To deal with this, contests offer rewards to attract solvers. So what is an innovation contest? I would assume that we all know what an innovation contest is to attend this session, but in short, an innovation contest is a way to source solutions to an innovation-related problem from an external crowd. The contest organizing firm cares only about the best solution from the crowd and splits its budget into prizes to incentivize crowd effort in generating solutions. So prizes motivate contest effort. And all this, how we have discussed so far, holds true when there is a single standalone contest. Yet, crowdsourcing platforms such as Innocentive display multiple concurrent dueling contests. The difference compared to the old view of contest is that here solvers must first self-select a contest in the first place, and then they determine the right effort to exert to generate solutions. Each of these multiple coexisting contests split their budgets into multiple prizes. And of course, each firm hosting contest is acting out of its own self-interest and cannot control what prizes their competitors would offer. So prizes motivate both contest selection and participation and contest effort. And the prize you offer can be an effective way to differentiate from a competitor. Yet the platform can play an active role here in guiding solvers' contest choice. So prizes and solver nudges motivate our main research questions. Specifically, we examine the following questions. On the solver side, how do solvers self-select contests? What is the equilibrium participation effort at the solver level? On the firm side, what prize allocation to offer in the presence of competing prize allocations? What's the equilibrium prize allocation among competing firms? Finally, on the platform side, does solvers' option to self-select a contest benefit or hurt the solvers themselves? How does solvers self-sorting into contests affect platforms' welfare? These are our research questions, but what do we know about this problem already? So far, literature focused on how to design the contest of a monopoly firm. This is still relevant as many firms host contests on their own websites. And there are many papers studying monopolistic contests with an emphasis on the plus plus here. Within the monopolistic contest literature, there are papers that study contests in which only a subset of solvers population participate. Finally, there are also papers that studied competing auctions. Contests are a special form of an auction. A contest is actually an all-pay auction, since every solver who participates must pay his effort, which is kind of a bid. Competing auctions are difficult to analyze mainly for two reasons. First, there is no known analog to the revelation principle to simplify the statistic behavior. Second, there is infinite regress. An allocation or mechanism chosen by a firm depends on the mechanism or allocation of their competitors, and so on and so forth. So the space of actions for firms is quite large, and it's unclear whether a fixed point would even exist here. So to answer the question, we don't know much, and it's a hard problem in general. To be precise, we didn't prove that this problem is hard. It's just a hard problem to tackle, at least for us. So since it's a hard problem, we will simplify it in the simplest non-trivial case on the solver side to derive insights on the competition among firms. Consider this simple example. There is a crowdsourcing platform with two competing firms, A and B. Suppose both firms have $1 budget to organize a single ideation contest. There is a population of four solvers who choose to submit a solution either to contest A or to contest B and have no other outside options. For simplicity, assume that upon selecting a contest, the quality of the solution submitted by a participant is a random variable that is drawn from a Gamble distribution. Consistent with past literature, we shall assume that the value received by the firms depends only on the best submission. Now, suppose that firm B chooses an arbitrary allocation with two rewards, whereas firm A offers also two rewards, alpha and one minus alpha. Since a solver's solution quality is not affected by his level of effort, by assumption, in equilibrium, each solver enters into contest A or contest B with probability P and 1 minus P, so that the expected utilities from these two contests are actually equal. To understand this equation, look at the left-hand side. Conditional that all other solvers are not in contest a solver who chooses to participate in contest A gets the top prize, alpha. Since solvers enter contest independently with the same probability, the chance three others are not present is simply 1 minus p to the third. Similarly, when at least two solvers are present, each of them gets a prize with equal probability, or they receive 1/2 overall in expectation, and so on and so forth for when conditional on other events having three or four solvers. So that gives the expected utility conditional on choosing to participate in contest A. In equilibrium, the expected utility conditional on entering contest B and entering into contest A must equal. And there is no closed form solution to this equation for a population of size n equals 4 or more. However, by standard comparative statistics arguments, we can show that solver participation is strictly increasing in the value of the top prize, or alpha. So the entry probability into contest A strictly increases in the top prize it offers. But what does firm A care about to maximize? Firm A offers prizes so that it maximizes the expected best participating solution in its contest. By law of order probability, this is simply the expected best noise conditional there are k equals 1, 2, 3, or 4 participants multiplied by the probability of that event. And this further simplifies in this example because we have focused on the Gamble noise. How does this objective now change with different prize allocations? We can show that this objective strictly increases in the entry probability. Intuitively, the more solvers that enter, the higher the expected best noise of them. So firm's objective increases in solver's entry probability, and that probability strictly increases in firm's top prize. Since this holds for any arbitrary feasible allocation chosen by firm B, what this implies is that allocating a single winner-takes-all prize is a dominant strategy for firm A. Similarly, the same argument holds for firm B. And this means that allocating a single winner-takes-all prize is the unique equilibrium for two competing firms in pure strategies. There are no other symmetric or asymmetric pure equilibria. Naturally, we do not consider mixed strategies. That is, we don't allow firms to randomize over reward allocations. Further, we do not restrict firms to choose the same allocation. But it turns out that in equilibrium, no firm has incentives to differentiate from its competitor. So, that is the first conclusion out of this simple example. If you understood this example, here's what we saw actually in the paper. In the paper, we extend the previous example to account for solver population of arbitrary size, and we also let solver self-select contest and exert effort upon entering. Also, we model solver output as additive effort plus noise, and there is this sensitivity parameter theta, which captures the extent that effort or noise drive the outcome. In particular, contests with theta equals zero are called ideation contests, that is, contests where effort doesn't really matter. It's all about numbers here. It's all about noise. Naturally, there are also contests where effort and noise matter to some extent, and these are the regular tournaments previous leaders have talked about. In innovation, noise plays a central role, and we are interested in contests with small theta, or even close to zero. Armed with this, let me state our first two main results. First, we prove that there exists an equilibrium allocation in pure strategies where each firm allocates multiple prizes of equal size. So this characterizes the equilibrium in prize allocations among competing firms. The precise form of the allocation depends on the noise distribution and the theta. However, when theta equals zero, or when noise distribution has an increasing failure rate, then both firms should choose a winner-takes-all prize. And that's the unique prize allocation equilibrium. Distributions such as the Gamble, Uniform, Normal are all IFR distributions. So every log concave distribution is also IFR, but not vice versa. So this extends the winner-takes-all optimality result known from the monopolistic contest to the case of contest with endogenous entry. So in equilibrium, firms allocate multiple rewards in general. But our second result shows that both firms choosing winner-takes-all is an epsilon equilibrium for sufficiently noise-driven innovation contests. For an intuition, note that participation requires a single winner-takes-all prize, but effort may require multiple rewards in general. When incentives for participation are sufficiently important to the firm, as opposed to effort incentives, winner-takes-all is an approximate best response to a competing allocation. So the practical insight here is that if your contest is mainly noise-driven as opposed to effort-driven, then using a single winner-takes-all prize approximates the optimal allocation. And this approximation improves with the dependence of contest outcome on its noise. So characterizing the equilibrium prize allocation is our first contribution. Second, we examine platform's role in improving crowdsourcing efficiency. In particular, we now return to on our previous example and focus on winner-takes-all allocations. We consider two systems. First, under what we call blind entry, solvers can freely self-select which contest they wish to participate in. Second, under nudged entry, the platform recommends a contest to its solver and solvers follow platform's nudges. We ask whether solvers and firms are hurt by such feature contests that nudge solver participation. It is intuitive that nudging solvers into contest would help the firms because nudging alleviates inter-firm competition. The proof is a simple application of Jensen's inequality. Interestingly, and quite surprisingly to us, nudged entry always benefits the solvers as well. That wasn't expected at all by us before writing the paper. Let's understand why solvers prefer nudged entry over blind entry. On the slide, I calculate the expected utility of the solvers under this example, under blind entry versus nudged entry. When k solvers enter, each of them has 1 over k probability to get the top prize. Then we use the law of total probability and calculate the solver's expected utility. In contrast, under nudged entry, it is guaranteed that there are 2 solvers per contest. This shows that solvers are strictly better off to follow platform's nudges. And we can show that following those nudges is an equilibrium. Finally, the platform is serving a coordination role in this setup to avoid mismatches between solvers and firms. Obviously, any other means that the solvers use to coordinate their entry will also work as well. As an example, consider a correlation device which randomly picks n over 2 numbers from 1 to n. Each solver choosing contest A, if his index is in the randomly chosen set, and choosing contest B otherwise, would be a symmetric correlated equilibrium, which is identical to the equilibrium in the NAT setting. Thus, from the technical perspective, Theorem 3 relies on the coordinating role of the platform that allows solvers to avoid excessive competition. With that, let me summarize our overall insights. Contest theory to date has largely focused on solvers' behavior, how to motivate solvers to exert effort, how to reduce solver information asymmetry, and so on and so forth. We elevate the discussion at the firm level. In this paper, we present a modeling framework which is applicable to settings that involve incentive mechanisms by which firms and agents self-select to contract and compete. More specifically, at the solver level decision-making, our model sheds new light into allocating participation and effort in the face of endogenous outside options. At the firm level decision-making, we study equilibria among firm design mechanisms that induce downstream equilibria among solvers. Such firms should be aware of their competitors. For example, how does your objective and overall contest characteristics position you compared to them? The paper is available online. Please send me an email with any feedback you have. Thank you.